Hi, I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making a Mexican appetizer. And I think you'll like it because it's really easy to make. It's very quick to do, so if you need something in just a few minutes, it doesn't take that long. It doesn't have parts that sit for a while. So I'm just going to go directly into making it. Over here at the stove, I have 1 pound of ground beef. And this is 85-15, meaning that it's 15% fat. So it's going to be a little fattier than most of the hamburgers that I use. But you just choose whatever kind that you like and it will be fine. What we're going to do is turn this on and I'm going to stir continually until I have this nice and browned, and then we can add some ingredients. My hamburger has been browned and I've poured off the excess fat. You can see that there's very little here in the bottom now. And the next item I'm going to add is tomatoes. These are canned tomatoes. You can use a 14.5 ounce can of diced tomatoes. If you don't find the diced tomatoes, then just dice them up yourself on a cutting board. So that goes in. And I did actually drain this and put what was left of the juice over in a little measuring cup here. It shows you that there's about 1/2 cup of tomato juice. And I didn't want this to be soupy, so I decided to add just the tomatoes at this point and then reserve that until I get all of this mixture the way I want it. And if it seems thick, then I will thin it down with the juice. But that's better than thinning it down with water. Okay, while I'm still over here at the stove, I want to discuss our seasoning. If you happen to run across a package of chili-o, that's made by French's, and it is a chili-flavored seasoning, so it's a very specific specifically oriented type of spice. If you happen to have that, then you would want to use 1/2 package. And I think I will use that just since I've used this other before. In fact, I did this on in June of 2012, and I called it taco seasoning. But it has a lot of nice Mexican spices, and you can use it for tacos or burritos, or enchiladas, fajitas. It's just great. I love using it. And when I use it, I quite often will use 1 tablespoon per 1 pound of meat. So in this case, it might be 1 tablespoon if you like things really spicy, but it is very spicy. So I would suggest that if you have made this yourself, or if you want to go in Betty's Kitchen and look for taco seasoning, then you can make this and have it for future meals. But I would just suggest, if you're just starting out with this, use 1/2 tablespoon for this mixture. And I'm just using 1/2 of this prepackaged seasoning. First thing is that you put your chili mixture on the bottom. I'm calling it the chili mixture because it has the hamburger, and it has the tomatoes, and it has the seasoning that is a chili seasoning. And if you don't use the chili seasoning, of course you can use that mixture, which I call taco seasoning, which, by the way, that's not the original amount that I made on June 2012. It has been replenished about 3 times. I try to keep it nice and fresh, but I use it a lot. I love it for a lot of different Mexican style dishes. So just put this along the bottom and spread it out. The next thing is you're going to use green onions. And this is 1 bunch of green onions. So we're just going to take these and kind of make an even layer. And the best thing to do is use your hands. And we only have 1 more ingredient and we have a little bit of work to do. But the next ingredient is sharp cheddar cheese, and it should be shredded. I have a 1-pound package here, and I'm just going to put that out I'm going to put some out here because I want to use my hands, but I don't want to contaminate this. I've probably got half this bag left, so for my version today, it's going to be 1/2 pound of shredded cheddar cheese. And it's spread with my hands, and I didn't get inside there with my hands, so I can seal that up and use it for something later. And that's about it. And this goes to a 350 degree oven, and it will bake for 10 to 15 minutes, and then I will show you how we finish up the dish. You can see this is what came from the oven, and it's so hot right now. I'm going to be using these shells to put them in, and these are tortillas, and they came from this bag, and they're called tortilla chips, and they are dippers. So if you wanted to, you could just put them in like that and dip out what you like and just eat. But since I'm trying to make this an organized plate, I'm going to just take some and leave it in the order that it's stacked. And what I think would be nice for one of these dippers, I'll put that in. Oh, dropped a little bit. And then it goes back to the plate, and then I'll get my next one here and do the same thing. So I'll be filling these and then I'll come back. Here's our finished plate of Mexican appetizers, and I think they look really good. So I can't wait for my bite over here, but I wanted to tell you I decided to put some fresh cilantro as a little bit of decoration, and that taste is so good that you can really put a lot on. In fact, if you want to, on each one, put a little sour cream and then put a little piece of cilantro, that will just make it taste extra special. So right here, I've picked off three of them. I'm not going to eat all of them for you. I'll just start with this one because it has so much cheese on it. And these are hot from the oven, and I did bake them for about 12 minutes. So it should vary from 10 to 15, whenever it looks good to you and you want to get it out. Everything was done when it went into the oven, so you don't have to worry about whether it's done or not. It just has to be to your taste. So this is cooled enough that I think I can just bite into it instead of taking a fork and opening it. And that's probably the way it will work if you have a party or something you're serving this at. These will be a little messy, maybe. Mmm, it tastes so good. Mmm. This is not going to be my appetizer tonight. This is going to be my supper. Mmm, I love it.